What's the advantage that we can take out of the whole control of the externality in our work?
To overcome externality within ourselves, each and every one comprises internality and externality, and he needs to integrate with the society, the study, and so on, in order to overcome his externality, to scrutinize his internality, and to connect his internality with the internality of others. And that way we reach the center of everyone, where it's certain that the Creator is awaiting us.
It's like the externality is actually directing us, it's guiding us.
You, or rather we, reach our central point, reaches a door, right? Like an iron gate, perhaps. And if it reaches in such a way where they all connect, then the door opens and the Creator says, well, where are you? Get in already. Yeah? And there you have a great table with an ox, right? At the end of correction, the Leviathan. It's all laid out on the table. Very nice, ready for the feast. All right? So do we have Moscow?
Рафа, вы говорите, что точка связи между нами – это самая главная наша цель.
Rav, you say that the point of connection between us is the central goal for us, and that we need to talk about it more. What can you even say here about this? Maybe we will try to do some workshop on it. I don't know. Well, you have nothing to say about it.
Think about it more and more. Think about it more and more, and then it will become more and more important to us, and we will feel how we can be together in that. How, rather, the more we become together, contract, so to speak, we'll be together with the Creator, we'll feel how He is at that point. I'm telling you from how I feel it. It's not just imagination. You will come to feel that He becomes more and more revealed there according to the power of the connection between us. And then we could, according to that power of connection, think of others, because the Creator cannot be connected to others, but rather only we are as Galgalta and I'm. We have Galgalta and I'm and the Chab, right? So we can be a conduit to the rest of the created beings, and by that we give Him contentment. When we connect, we don't give the Creator contentment. This is only preparation in potential. However, when we connect and connect the others to us, and He can reach the others who He can't reach by Himself, then He enjoys this. He's delighted. And also, He can act on us by reducing the lights, restricting them. If we don't want to work with others, then He also stops us from advancing, because why should we advance? Then we remain in a minimal, in an initial sort of form, a very tiny sense and illumination, tiny sense of the Creator, because we don't need any more if we don't want to connect to lower layers. And then He stops the upper light from reaching us from above, and then we don't feel that we have a connection to Him. And also, He increases through the surrounding light the desires of the general vessel, and then they pressure us, and then we get pressure from above through the lack of upper light, and from below by the demand of the uncorrected vessels. And then we are thus compelled, as Israel in exile, as it's called, to begin to work. And if not, then these pressures from externality and from above will grow more and more until there will be no choice. We'll have to do it.